Okay, what's up, YouTube? Long time no see. Let's get right to the point. So there's a new event that lets you do this Una's task. And this is really good because this Una's task gives you 25k silver, 5 leapstones per day. And most importantly, it gives you a plus 1 Una's task coupon that lets you do an extra Una's daily. So basically, this is like doing Lopang and any of the 5 Leapstone quests combined. It also refunds you the Una entry or whatever you want to call it because it gives you a plus 1 back after you do it. Now that's just from the Una's quest, but after you do the Una enough times, from the reputation rewards, you can get a bunch of other stuff. You can just check the picture above. So this means that each of your characters can net you an extra 25k silver and 5 Leapstones daily just from doing this quest in the middle of your normal 3 Unas. Now, if you're lazy and you don't really want to change up your routine too much, you can just do 4 Unas per character and you'll see a nice little surge of silver and leapstones. But what you can also do is, because these coupons are tradable, or I should say roster bound, you can actually funnel the excess plus 1 coupons from, say, your Lopang alts or your sub characters to your main. That lets you do up to 6 Unas tasks on your main per day, which can give you a lot of leapstones, especially if you're still pushing for Bell Heart. Now to do the actual quest, you have to finish the pink quest chain that you can find in every town, and after that you'll unlock the Una. After you unlock the Una, you can accept the quest, but you still have to actually start it by talking to the event NPC, and you can find them in every major town. What I mean by start the quest is that just like when you accept the Lopang quest, you can't actually do it until you go to Lopang Island and talk to the terminal to start the quest. So this Una works exactly the same way, and once you start the quest, you'll need to visit any of these NPCs to give them a present. Now there's a lot of options for what NPCs you can actually visit, but basically it's most of the major story characters. The real problem is, after you talk to the first NPC and you give them the present, the quest will ask you to go to a second NPC and also give them a present. So this is kind of annoying because you don't really want to travel. The most important thing of Una is doing it quickly, right? And you know, we hate wasting time. So there are some towns that have both story NPCs pretty close by that let you do both halves of the quest. So some of this is Vern, you can talk to Avel the Knight and Eildin the Queen, or Yorn, you can talk to Neria in the inn, and then Khazar where the throne is, but both of these are still pretty far away and you have to walk, you know, a non-zero amount to get to the other NPC. So by far the fastest way to do this is by going to Arthetine, and you can talk to Sasha and then Bastion, and you can see why that's fast because if you've done the story, you know that those two are literally right next to each other in the same room. So how do we actually route our Unas to do this quickly? So we have to actually do love delivery sometime before we finish all three of our Unas, but that being said, there is a pretty optimal route, and I didn't make this, but so credits to Yuvaris from Monster. So this involves doing the 3 Leapstone quests plus love delivery. And the main quests people do are the two in Phaeton and Mokomoko Island. And what you'll want to do is you'll want to do both the quests in Phaeton and turn in both quests. And then at this point, you will TP to the bottom left of Kalaja and start the love delivery quest by talking to the NPC. Now you can bifrost to Sasha and Bastion and complete the love delivery quest. And if you don't have the bifrost set up for Sasha and Bastion, I would recommend doing that on basically all of your characters, at least until this event is over. After you finish love delivery in Arthetine, you can get the plus 1 Una, use it, and that will give you one more Una's task for the day for a total of 4. Now for your last quest that you just got refunded to you, you can go ahead and finish Mokomoko like you would have normally. So that lets you do 4 Leapstone Unas and basically nets you an extra 5 Leapstones per day. If you are doing it on a Lopang character, it is actually still worth to do because again, it gives you 25k silver, so it's like doing one extra Lopang, give or take. And what you want to do is accept your 3 normal Lopangs, that's normally Vern, Arthetine, and Trishire, and you want to accept love delivery. So you want to go to Lopang Island, accept all 3 of the quests, and then bifrost to Arthetine, which you probably already have set up because you've been doing Lopang. You would turn in your Lopang quest at Arid Path like normal, and then you will manually triport to Stern at the top, and the NPC to start love delivery is actually right next to the triport. So on the way up to the administrator's room where Sasha and Bastion are, you would start love delivery, go to Sasha and then go to Bastion, and you'll finish love delivery. Then you will use the plus 1 Una's token, right? And that will basically give you 2 quests remaining, which you will use to finish your last 2 Lopangs, which is Vern and Trishire. So if you're just doing 4 quests on each of your characters, you can basically stop here and that is fine. So enjoy your bonus 25k silver and 5 leap stones per character per day. But if you want to be a little more optimal, or if you have, you know, 1 or 2 characters that you are trying to push even further, like for Brelhard, like I said, you can actually put the +1 Unas coupons into your roster storage. And so what that means is that instead of doing the extra +1 Una on a character that you don't really care about, what you can do is put the +1 Una's coupons in your roster storage. And then you can use those coupons on your main, because your main can do up to 6 Una's per day. The maximum is 6, with so 3 base and 3 +1s. And the easiest way to do this is you might have to kind of change your routine a little bit, because I don't know about you guys, but I start with the dailies on my main first. But what you want to do is you just want to start on your sub characters first. So your low paying characters, your non-main characters, and you want to bank up all those +1s and put them in your roster storage. And then on you go on your main last, or your mains plural if you have more than one, and you want to do the following quests. Just like we did with the 4 Leapstone Una route above, except after we finish Moko Moko, we want to go into the roster storage and we want to use 2 of the +1 coupons. That will give us 2 extra quests for the day. And you can basically do any 2 Leapstone quests that you like, but generally I think doing Hope Island is probably pretty fast if you have the Bifrost for it. And as well, Frozen Sea is pretty fast. That's the one in Shushire where you kill the bandits. If you're like me though, and you're too lazy to actually set up 5 different Bifrosts or whatever, I will probably just do the 1 at Hope Island and then use an instant complete ticket on Frozen Sea, Kalthurt, Alakir, or Hypnos. Doesn't matter which one, they all give 5 leap stones because I have like 100 of these in the roster storage. So I'll leave the link to this doc with all the routes and stuff written out, and you can check it out yourself. But if you really want to squeeze out the maximum efficiency from this Unas while the event lasts up until May 10th, do check it out. The other thing is that I don't know if this route will change a little bit after we unlock the next stage of the Una, because you know, as you go through the reputation stages, like if you do this one 9 times or whatever it is, you'll actually get a different quest for part 2 sometimes. So I don't know if this will hold up, but if it doesn't, I will try to update this doc. And so if you're watching this video maybe like 2 weeks later, make sure you check out the doc and look for any changes. That's gonna be it for this one. Short and sweet. Hope you guys are having fun with the new patch. Bye you.